Our district and school leaders are very excited to have school campuses reopened to in-person instruction. They see the joy in students' eyes and the real engagement of young people in their learning.
Well, it's just wonderful seeing students. We all get giddy when we actually see live students. It's just been so long, and that's why teachers teach, is because we love being around kids.
We spent an entire year, over a year, without children at a school. And having little feet and little voices fill our hallways again just warms my heart. It was so wonderful to see.
I think parents initially were a little hesitant about what to expect on school campuses. And after that very first day of return to in-person, parents were enthusiastic about how well prepared the school campuses were and how well their children did with that return to in-person instruction.
Me siento muy segura de dejar aquí mis hijos hoy en este día, su primer día, porque definitivamente ellos necesitaban el regreso a la escuela.
During the pandemic, we learned that schools are essential and vital to the community. In addition to the academic programming that schools provide, they're also the hub of community activity, a place where many services are provided. It's really essential that our young people are able to return to school. We know that their social emotional development, their academic development, and their physical health are all going to be better served as we return to in-person instruction.
When we have to close schools, one of the first steps that we took really was engaging our community and our parents in the process of developing a task force to talk about reopening. And through the work of the task force and surveying our communities, coming back and reflecting together as a team, we were able to establish certain criteria that made it safe to reopen.
All of our schools engaged in regular and consistent communication and deliberations around their plans for reopening. There was an all hands on deck approach with all the leadership, from school board members to superintendents, community members, and all of the staff as well. School campuses worked to prepare themselves by understanding what their community was looking for in terms of safety. Fewer students attended in person at the beginning, and then over time there was a gradual increase in the availability of in-person instruction.
We are very grateful to all of those families who trust their children to us, and I promise you we're going to take good care of them.
Schools have taken many measures to ensure the safe reopening to in-person instruction, conducting site walkthroughs to see what the school campus needed in terms of physical distancing, hand washing stations, improved ventilation. They've been stocking up on PPE. They've engaged in significant cleaning protocols. They've established signage, and additionally, schools have been working with students and families to use face coverings and to ensure that everyone who needs a face covering has one.
Our children will soon be able to all return back to play, to learn, to thrive together in person as a child should. Thank you.
Disease transmission is extremely low. Vaccines are widely available, and our schools have been practicing and implementing safety protocols for well over a year and a half. We know far more about COVID-19 now than we ever did before. As we transition to a new school year, the most important thing we can each do is ensure that when it's our turn, we get the COVID-19 vaccine. I fully anticipate as the 2021-2022 school year begins, we will be back to full in-person instruction, and we're going to see children on campus thriving.